What's good, fam? Welcome back to another video. This is a introduction to Adobe Illustrator, how to cartoon yourself. This is class number three, I think. Yeah, it's class number three. And in this class, what we'll be focusing on is the shading. And I'm gonna try to make it as basic as possible, like the line works. I try to make them as basic, and then after that, we're gonna recreate it. The same artwork. I'm gonna recreate the same artwork. This time, trying to put more details into it and make it more advanced. Okay, first thing. Last time, I think we managed to unite, to expand everything and unite. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy it, copy the layers, then lock the top layer so that we work on the second layer. After that, we are gonna just open our reference. What do I usually do when I make the shading? Hold on a second. Okay. We're back again. Okay, well, as I was saying, all I like to do when I'm making my shading, I like to try and make it as close as possible as to the skin tone that I can see on the reference. I don't know if it makes sense, but maybe when I do it, it'll make more sense. Okay. That was just me. I don't know why I did that. Let me go to the base color black. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna click on this, then I'm gonna drag it as slow as possible and make sure that the color that's on the color panel, it's closer to the color that I can see on the reference. If the reference was this color, it was dark like this color, I would have dragged it a little bit lower. But since it's a little bit lighter, I'm gonna leave it somewhere here and then look for the color that's almost similar to it. That's the basic. And I'm gonna be here. I'm gonna settle there. Let's turn off the reference and drag the color we just choose. And then I think it's pretty good. I don't know how you guys are doing that side. If you have any question, please don't hesitate to the comment section, ask whatever. If you feel it's something that you need, please send via inbox. Please don't hesitate. Okay, after that, you're gonna send it to back, arrange. You right click on your mouse, then arrange, then send to back. Select everything and then properties, and then we can mesh so that the color and the align works could be one thing. After that, just look at the layers panel. Make sure that before you merge everything, make sure that you can see your reference, your line works on top of the color that you chose, as you have sent the color to the back side. I don't know if that makes sense, but yeah. After that, you select the color, right click, then isolate selected group. Select the color panel and then delete. You're gonna delete the colors that you don't need. I'm gonna delete the colors that I think we don't need. We don't need this one because this is the space between the dread. After that, you're gonna lock all the black line, the line works. You're gonna remain only with the color or the color of the skin tone. As you can see here, the last line work is here. You're gonna lock from there and to the top, then isolate, exit isolation mode. Oh no, not yet. Let's go to isolation mode. You can double click to go into isolation mode again, then hold. If you want to select multiple things at the same time, you hold shift and then you can select multiple things. For the eyes, I like to make them white, just white. I don't want to make them to be a white like the background, but they should be a little bit white. So I think this white will do for me. And then the color of the skin that's inside the eye, I don't know what it's called. That one I just like go to the top and then drag until I feel it's dark enough to, yeah, something like this. The teeth are a little bit lighter. I think somewhere here will do. Don't make them too white. I think that will do. The lips, the lower lip is always lighter than the upper lip. The upper lip is darker. So when you choose the color of the lower lip, make sure you go up and then this side go down so that it retains that color of the base. It doesn't lose its color. Something like this. And then the upper lip go down and then still go down again this side. Then you end up having something like this. I exit the isolation mode by double clicking. Then what you're gonna do from here, you're gonna copy this layer we've been working on. And then you copy it, make a copy of it, lock it, and then let's turn it off for now so that we can delete the color from this one. The reason why we're deleting the color from this one is so that we can be able to make our shades. And remember to lock your layer so that when you delete the color, it doesn't also delete your line works. Lock it for now, and then let's turn back the original work to see if we still have our color. Okay, there it is. We're gonna make a new layer. This is our working layer that we're gonna start shading on. So for beginners, I'm not gonna make many lines, or I'm just gonna try to show you how to do the shading. I'm gonna not make it much complicated. I hope you guys will follow along. And then that being turned on the reference, let's make the first shadow. The first shadow, let's make it a little bit let's make it dark. Let's make it the darkest one. So you're gonna go as down as possible. Don't make it too dark, but and then don't forget to go down the side so that we still have the color of our reference of our yeah, it still retains that it's still similar to this color of the base color that we have of the skin tone. Okay, then press N for the pencil tool. Let's check if we are satisfied with the color. Okay, I think it's fine. I think it's good. And then let's delete for now. Control Z, turn off this layer. Just turn off this layer so that you can work on the reference. Don't worry if you are having trouble keeping up with the tutorial, with choosing the colors and everything. It's something that needs you to work on it every now and then. Eventually you'll get the grasp of it. Okay, now that we choose our first shade, the darkest one, we're gonna try to cover all the darkest parts on the face from here. As you can see, it's dark. Even this place is dark, and this side, even here, is a little bit dark. Yeah, so let's do it. Let's start from the nose and then trying to make your line as simple as possible. And then okay, and then the top of the eye. Okay, I hope you guys are managing to follow along. If there's a step that you are left behind with, don't hesitate to contact me. I'll try my level best to help you guys. I'm still learning also, so I think it's best if we share the knowledge that we have, you know. And then let's fill this area out. You are feeling the darkest part. This part here is a little bit light, so you're gonna leave it for another shade that we're gonna make. And then let's do this place here. And then let's fill out this one. Now let's check how everything is progressing. Turn on and switch off the lid. As you can see, it's not that bad, it's not that bad. And then yeah, let's continue. Let's turn on the reference and turn off this layer. If you have two monitors or something like that, you can just choose to follow to turn off your reference, then work with the reference of your with looking at the reference from your other monitor. But since I'm using a laptop and yeah, I have only one screen. I pressed control. So I'm gonna be turning off the reference every now and then so that I can be able to have a better look. And then let's do this part here. Let's go to this side. Okay, let's see. Yep, I think it's going well. Oh, I forgot this part here. Let's go it. You should know which scar which sorry 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 for that. Which color tone to use and where and how. For example, if I used a darker, a more lighter skin tone here, it will have been more difficult for me. Oh, I pressed that again. Sorry. It will have been more difficult for me to select the. What am I talking about? Okay, never mind that. I zoned out for a minute there. Okay, let's fill the ear. Okay, I think now it's fine. Lock the layer. Let's create another layer. Here you're gonna choose a more lighter skin shade than the previous one. This is our previous shade, so you're gonna choose a more lighter one than this one. Here's the easiest way to do it. You can just draw a circle here. Okay, obviously it's gonna look like the same thing because it's the same color, even though they are in two different layers. After that, you go to edit. Then edit colors and color artwork. Here we're gonna reduce the density of your color. As you can see, it shows that you can reduce and try to match the colors as much as you can. I think that will do for me. And then you can delete this one. You don't need it as you have already made a copy of it. And then let's try to do the second shadow. Okay, that's nice. The side also. Please bear with me, it's my first time doing this online tutorial, so my explanations could be mixed up. Yeah, I may not be clear, but please, if you don't understand, please contact me, ask me. I'll try my level best to give you the help that you need. Yeah, what you are doing here now is you are filling in the second shade. Let's see how it's going so far. Okay, I think it's going good. I think it's going good. And then let's fill out this part also. This is the second shadow to the darkest one. So look for a shadow. If you're using a different reference, look for a shadow that's a little bit dark. But yeah, that's a little bit dark than the base color and a little bit lighter than the first shadow that we made. The first shadow should be the darkest one, and this one should be a little bit dark, lighter than it. Oh. Okay. Let's check. Okay. I think it's fine. So far it's good. And then let's fill this part here. Let's fill it off. As you can see, this part is a little bit dark, so I'm just gonna fill it. Yeah, let's check it out. Let's see how it's going. Okay, I think it's good. It's good. It's going good. And then let's fill this part off. Okay. Nice. For now we're gonna be doing only three shadows. We're gonna be adding only three shadows, not to complete, because those are the major shadows that you have to have in the artwork. The artwork should have at least three shadows. At least the minimums will be at least three shadows. Yeah. Okay. I think it's good. It's good. Let's check. Okay, let's create the last shadow. It should be lighter than this one. So, the trick that I just showed you, just draw a circle. On a different layer, don't forget, on a different layer, select the layer, and then let's make it lighter than the previous one. Nope. Okay, I think it's fine. Okay, then delete it. Now we're gonna fill off the spaces. This one gives you the freedom to fill as much space as you want. If it doesn't have any lighting on it, like for example the spaces, you can see this part is very light. If you're shading on a part that's not light like that, then you can use this last shadow to cover everything. You can use it to cover everything.